Cover letter or an email body text is a challenging area because normally when we try and complete our resume format and also do our video resume, which is very, very important nowadays, we try and figure out as to how the cover letter can be, and we search for same exercise as we have done for resume, find it in the internet and maybe copy and paste. But nowadays, cover letter is no more in the fashion, as the cover letter is imbibed in the email text body or body text. So how it is, let's try and understand the nuances of writing an effective cover letter or an effective email text body. And this is being brought by none other than skill influencer Manish Nair. So this particular cover letter is a three paragraph approach, but before that, let me also explain to you that it's an additional communication tool. You are communicating one more, it's an opportunity for you all to communicate to your prospective employer one more time, and this cover letter or email text body gives you a perfect timing to exhibit that particular skill. So basically, this cover letter or an email text body is a three paragraph approach. The first paragraph is essentially the reference paragraph, where you're trying to give the prospective employer a reference point as to where you have picked up this job from. Second paragraph will be work experience or internship that you have done related to that job profile or job description. And the third paragraph is the letter of appreciation, award, or strength, in case if you do not have an appreciation or award during your internship, then you can mention your strength, how it coincides with that particular job description and makes you qualify or makes you the best fit for that particular job. So let's try and understand. The first paragraph is called as the introduction paragraph, and what it essentially has is how you have heard about the position. So the source of this particular position that you have come across, whether it you have come across from the advertisement, paper advertisement, or the SMS alert or the email alert, I think you need to figure it out and then mention it subtly. Again, I'm telling you all that I will give you a template at the end of the video for you all as a ready reference, so that you can refer it and maybe evolve with your own good cover letter or your email text body. So if someone referred you, you can write his or her name or mention the name of your contact who has passed on this information of this particular vacancy to you. Or maybe if it is a paper newspaper advertisement, then you need to write the newspaper source and date it when it was featured. How your work experience pertains to your desired or targeted job, you can subtly say that please find my experience, educational background attached in the form of resume herewith. This is where you need to complete the first introductory paragraph, which clearly takes away the credit of where you have picked up this job from and what is that you possess in terms of experience or qualification in the first introduction itself. Now, this why you are interested in this position can also be very well mentioned. I think two lines is enough for you to complete the introductory paragraph of cover letter or email text body. The middle paragraph would entail that you are an exceptional hire. Why you are an exceptional hire? I think you need to figure it out again, matching what kind of an experience you have, what kind of strength that you have. In case you have three strengths which are matching to the job description, I think you need to select one each and maybe map it or assign it with the job description. Pick the job description and match it with your strength and write it there in the middle paragraph. Often, middle paragraph is also denoted as the magical paragraph because you need to, you know, magically put your strength mapping to this job description and bring about a relevance. That's the reason it is called as magical paragraph. The third paragraph would be essentially your strengths matching your key skills. So you are in a way reiterating your passion, your interest with the job, why it makes you only you to say that you are the best fit for that particular job, right? Thank them for the time and consideration, because this is the last paragraph and you'd like to definitely say the parting line. So time and consideration both need to be thanked, and who else? The prospective employer that you're talking to. So three paragraph, distinct meaning, all three different from each other, but clearly state what is not getting featured in your resume format is getting featured in your cover letter. So cover letter or email text body is an additional advantage for you to communicate more effectively and maybe speak the unspoken part in your with your in reference to your resume format and complete the communication as more consolidated one till the point where cover letter is concerned. So what I've done is I've given you a ready reckoner or a ready reference of a template of cover letter or a text body part, but this is typically what we all know of writing an application. So let's say Ashish Dongre is writing, is the applicant. So he writes his complete name, address, his PIN code with his phone number, the date comes the second part, and what comes as a third part is the receiver's name, his address, along with his PIN code, followed by the fourth part, which is the subject, which I have not mentioned it here because of the size of the slide. So subject becomes a fourth part, and the fifth part is the salutation, where I'm directly designating dear Mr. Smith, dear Mr. Nair. And here I'm trying to explain the three paragraphs, which are written very discreetly, one different from the other two. So here I begin. I'm responding to your advertisement in the City Tribune, which got featured in the City Tribune, dated 22nd December 2008, regarding the trainee network engineer position. Please find enclosed my resume showing my education, experience and background. So this becomes the first paragraph, as we are trying to give complete meaning of where I've picked this job from and what is this kind of experience or education I have as a background. Now the second paragraph essentially explains the experience part. So I have 1 year of experience in the networking field. I have received 2 employee awards. So awards, recognition, rewards, recognition, citation or any appreciation which you have gathered doing internship or any kind of an exposure towards the job, part-time, full-time, I think you need to write it here. I have received 2 employee awards while working in my current company. So you can mention while doing the internship or the project. I believe I would excel in the networking field because I find it a challenging and rewarding career, and because my qualification and interest is in the same field. So this completes an authentic, serves as an authentic menu for as second paragraph to the HR. Now the third paragraph would be, I would appreciate an opportunity to discuss this in detail. I'm available for an interview at a mutually convenient time. Thank you for your time and consideration. Now this is what the entire text body part, email text body or the cover letter looks like. Three distinct paragraph, very meaningful and adding on to what you have written in your resume format. So this looks to me at least very appealing. Now yours sincerely, because you know the name of that person, the receiver. That's the reason, yours sincerely, Ashish Dongre. So this is serving you all as a template for your text body, email or cover letter. Mind you, if you have any question, you are more than welcome to shoot it so that I answer them one by one. Thank you so much, and here's wishing you all best luck.